Hello you, it's Josh here. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another update flash. Today we have one that people are probably going to be quite excited about because finally they have added water coasters in. I mean, a lot of people suspected this, especially because of the brand new water ride that they just added that I cannot remember the name of, that we covered in the last update flash. But people have been wanting a water coaster for quite a while because it's one of those coasters that's just really interesting and allows you to do some very cool stuff. But anyway, let's get on with it, shall we, without further ado. So, yeah, except from that, there's not really much else that's been added in, but we'll just go through that first. So if we just go into our roller coasters here, we could scroll the coaster, and as you can see right here, we've got a water custom track. Now, this is obviously quite similar to the splash boats that were added in before, but it's obviously a bit more, it's a bit more adapted to the actual coaster sort of look. So here you are, you've got your station right here, and of course, you have your track, which is more of this sort of thingy. And if we just go up here a little bit, we'll just go up slightly here just so you can get a sort of idea. And then what we do here is we can go down like this. And as you can see, it's kind of more of this skeleton looking thingy like it would normally be. And then if we just go down here, we can then go into splash down like this, guys. And this will turn it into water here. So that's how you kind of change between the two things. And it makes it very, very interesting. As you can see, you can do pretty much all the roller coaster stuff that you could normally on a roller coaster when you get to the roller coaster part. But then you also have the fact that you've also got a water coaster. And then also, I should probably point out that if once you want to go up again and out of this splashdown, you simply just do something like this to come back out of it. It's pretty simple, honestly. It's very intuitive. You haven't got the stupid problems that you had with the splash boats where, you know, if you where there was like you could only incline by a certain amount and it was stupid and dumb and whatever. This is pretty free and it works very, very well here. The only thing that I would have liked to have seen is you'd be able to take off this like tub around here, because then say if you wanted to do like a lake around this, you could. Although you can still do that. It's just that you will still see this blue outline around here, and honestly, it's not the end of the world. It's just one of those things that it'd be quite cool to see, and it'd give you a lot more freedom. But I understand why it's here, because, you know, players who aren't as going into such detail as sort of people like me, they will probably turn that off and go, "Oh, look, he's floating water," and it'll look stupid. So I understand that. But yeah, overall, I really like how it looks. We probably need to extend this station here, don't we? Because it's not actually long enough. Now, of course, I'm pretty sure this just goes in one single trains here. Yeah, you can't increase because that's just what a water coaster is like. Here is what the thingies look like. I actually really like this model. It's one of my favorite coaster train models in the entire game because it looks so detailed and also just looks so realistic. You know, this is the sort of thing you would see. Oh, God. This is the sort of thing you would see in like a real theme park, especially on a water coaster. It's kind of got that sort of like, you know, pirate ship look to it, but it also just looks so generic. Let's just turn down the chain lift here and we can have a look at this here, track friction up to, there we go, and gravity all the way up. So we'll have a look at this quickly here. And you can just see here how it looks really, really, let me move myself out of the way. It looks really, really pretty, and it looks just really high modeled and detailed as well. You see you've got these lovely little like these little traction pads on the side even here. And then the seats are even very detailed and very nice. And I like how they haven't just plastered a massive fucking theme park Tycoon 2 logo on the front like they did with the water coaster, because that's something that a lot of people didn't like, including me. And then I also like how you've got this black tub at the bottom where the water would go, and it also has this slight little lip to separate it. Honestly, it's perfect in my eyes. Now, there'll be some people who don't like this, I'm guessing, and they'll go, "Oh, well, you know, it's not generic enough," which I agree with slightly. Like, if you're not doing a pirate area and you want to have, like, more of a, like an adventure, like Aztec water coaster or something like that, then maybe it'll look a little bit weird. But in general, this looks really nice, especially if you're, like, you know, a new player or anything like that. This is going to be really easy for them people to use. Anyway, The only other things that really been added in is that you can now use precision build mode on mobile, which is pretty exciting for mobile users, I'm guessing. I don't use mobile because in my eyes it's stupid. but if you do, if your only option is mobile, then good for you guys because you now have precision build mode, which I'm guessing you are all quite excited about there. And as well as that, there's just loads of bug fixes. You've got some streaming adjustments, UI adjustments, internal changes, fixed the problem where trains wouldn't go over chain lifts properly. And there's some more minor issues that have been fixed. That was the sound of my phone turning off because I'm dumb and I can't remember all of the little thingies. But anyway, yeah, that's pretty much everything. This has been quite a short video because, like I said at the start, there's not really much that's gone on in this update. I mean, this is quite a big thing. I mean, there's not many separate things. It's mainly just this big water coaster here, which I think looks lovely, and I'm very excited to have it. I think it'll look very cool, especially in, like, adventure theme parks and stuff like that. If you use it correctly, and I'm sure a lot of people are going to be excited about this because they've been wanting this for quite a while here. But anyway, yes, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please do leave a like and subscribe. You can check out my Patreon if you really enjoyed it. You can check out my Twitch and Discord to go chat with me and watch my live streams. And of course, there's my Discord as well. I don't know if I already said Discord, but oh well, other channels. Goodbye.